surrenders. What's it gonna take for someone to defend her? If we all agree that we're equal as people, then why can't we see what is evil?
Thank you. Good morning, good morning. Good morning. Hey, Priscilla, how are you? I'm good, thanks for asking. Good morning, Monica. I should have brought another bottle of water over here.
Off the color, the structure was made to make us the enemy.
Thank you, Jay.
All of the names you refuse to remember. Was somebody's brother, friend, or a son to a mother that's crying. I can't breathe.
Hey, Latanya. Grand Rising, Grand Rising. How's everybody today? Oh, thank you so much, Reese. I appreciate that. This is the channeled song for this message. We're doing a collective energy check, and this is the channeled song. So y'all give me the 3,000 likes so we can get into this. Grand Rising. I'm good. Thank y'all for asking. Thanks for the follow.
Whipped and confined, this is the American pride. It's justifying a genocide.
If you are new here, I am a reader, so I'll be doing reading.
To take a black life, land of the free, to bring a gun to a peaceful fight for civil rights.
That way you guys can see the cards a little bit more, I think. So I pushed it out like that.
Generations of pain, fear, and anxiety.
Hey, hey,
equality,
hey.
Is walking without intuition, saying the protector
and
the killer
Pisces
is
too.
Wearing the same
happy birthday
uniform. The revolution is not televised. Media perception is
thank you, Ashanti.
So it's lies in the headlines.
Thank you. I feel love. I feel love. Thank you. I feel love.
We breathe the same and we bleed the same, but still we don't see the same.
Thank you. The glasses are from
Zlul. We seek justice. We are past fear. We are fed up eating your shit because you think your so-called black friend validates your wokeness and erases your racism. That kind of uncomfortable conversation is too hard for your trust fund pockets to swallow. To swallow the strange fruit hanging from my family tree because of your audacity to say all men are created equal in the eyes of God, but disparage a man based on the color of his skin. Do not say you do not see color. When you see
thanks,
us,
Coretta.
You see us.
You too, ma'am. So that song is I Can't Breathe by her. If you haven't heard it, please listen to the lyrics of that song. It will open your eyes to a lot of things, especially if you don't really follow some of the police shootings that have gone down. But basically, she's just speaking the truth about a lot of things that's going on in the world and mostly with race, okay? So anyway, listen to the song. It's called I Can't Breathe by her, okay? So we're going to get into this reading. This is a collective energy check. So whatever comes out is what spirit needs us to see, okay? So it's just like, no, I really don't think she's saying don't see color. She's not saying don't see color. We want you to see us for who we are. Okay? You really need to listen to the song, okay? And listen to the end part where she's speaking. It's very eye-opening for a lot of people, I'm sure. Okay, so we're going to get into this. We're going to start with the Elemental Oracle. by Stacy DeMarco. Okay. Let me put my jazz on. Coming to this reading, spirit, for the collective that's gathered here. Show me what I need to see. 1-8-7-6-8-0-8-9-0-1-7. What is that? Why are we putting up numbers? What's going on? Well, thank you so much. I'm still in my night clothes, y'all. Show me what I need to see, please, spirit. Good morning. Good morning. Show me what I need to see for this collective here. What is the overall energy for this collective? Show me what I need to see. Bottom of the deck is joy, music. So maybe some of you are getting more into your music. Maybe some of you use music to zone out, to get away from your everyday. Okay, maybe you tend to use music to calm yourself. We got change behind that wind. So there could be some changes coming towards us as a collective. Okay. Winds of change is what I'm hearing. Could be some storms coming up. I feel like Spirit is asking you to just maintain a peacefulness about yourself. But 28 is a 10, so it's about an ending. So something could be ending for the collective, and something could be beginning. Joy could be beginning. Okay? Show me what I need to see for the collective, for the overall energy. Yeah, hey, Zoe. All right. So we got depth coming out. Lake. So maybe there's things that are being uncovered, more deep things for the collective right now, not just within yourself, but within the world. Like, look underneath this house. There's a whole nother space under here. So I definitely feel like there could be things that are being uncovered today, as always. Also feel like this person in the water is taking some type of a deep dive into themselves. You could be a water sign. You could live near a lake. You could have red hair. Okay, let's see what that one is. Depth number 31, which is a 4, which is about your stability. The house is on top of. That's the stability. You could be thinking about your stability. You could be thinking about moving. All right. So do not take the shallow alternative. Deep dive. Do the research. Do not cut corners. You may not be seeing the whole picture. So take your time with a decision. So there could be a decision that you're getting ready to come towards, or that's coming towards you, that you're going to have to make. And Spirit is asking you to make sure that you do the research on something that you may be getting ready to get yourself into. Okay. Let's move on to the Gods and Titans. The Gods and Titans by Stacy DeMarco. Tell me what I need to see. I'm not getting anything really from that card other than I feel like there's a clearing that's getting ready to happen. With the wind of change coming on the bottom of that deck, and then to the skies being very clear, the water being crystal clear, I just feel like the winds of change are blowing away the things that the collective no longer needs right now. And I feel like Spirit is asking you to deep dive within yourself as a collective, part of the collective, you know, to understand that this is just a clearing, that the skies are going to return to normal. The skies are going to return to blue. You know, there's not going to be all stormy and stuff forever. Show me what I need to see for the collective. Good morning. Well, I'm sorry to hear that, Ashanti. Gotta start making better words come out of your mouth. Is it Joan? But I don't have the money. I don't have the money right now. I'm working on a plan to move into my own place. So make sure that you don't have it as a negative, because there's always a way for you to find the way to do it, okay? But you gotta trust that spirit can bring it forward, and you gotta use your talents to do it. Show me what I need to see for the collective on today. What does the collective need to be made aware of? Bottom of the deck is inventiveness. I just said, you can make a way. When you have a determination to get somewhere, to get something, to be resourceful, you will find a way. Good morning, baby girl. You have got to learn to lean in on your circle. And if you don't have that, then you need to research and find out, how can I make this move happen for me? How can I make whatever I'm trying to do happen for me? Use your creativity, okay? Good morning. Use your creativity. Write down the things that you know you can do in order to make the money that you need in order to get the place. Trust me, when you start making those steps, spirit's going to bless you. Things are going to start coming towards you, but you got to show spirit that you're focused on what you're trying to invent here. Show me what I need to see for this collective. What do I need to see? For this collective. Thank you. We got cycles coming out, oh Lord. Bottom of the deck is wisdom. So you have the wisdom. You have the know-how. Wisdom is tough, okay? You have what you need inside of you to get what you need to get. But you have to uncover it. You need to dive deep within yourself with this depth here and uncover it. So we got cycles coming out. Cycles is something that, we all go through. Some of the cycles you leave behind. Some of the cycles you continue to do until you learn not to continue the cycle. So let's see what it has to say to us today, okay? Helios. Know that personal patterns, positive or negative, may be playing out in your life right now. Plug into the cycles of nature for renewal and vitality. So spirit is urging you to get outside, okay? Maybe you're going through some type of a rebirth or something like this here, some type of transformation. Helios illuminates the patterns and cycles in your life, the productive ones and the ones you would rather interrupt. Consider what cycles you may be caught in. You could be continually responding to someone's treatment of you in unhealthy ways, procrastinating on completing a project, or eating a good breakfast and exercising. Whatever the cycle, it's important to notice it and honor it before deciding whether it's good for your life or a cycle you need to bust out of. Give me a second, y'all. I'm sorry, I'm waiting on something. have a delivery coming, guys. I have to get it in a minute, okay? Okay, so I definitely feel like you guys are closing out cycles. I feel like Spirit is telling you guys to deep dive. Figure out what cycles you want to keep in your life and ones you need to let go of. Because something is coming in. I just feel that for the collective. So Spirit is asking you to let go of things that no longer serve you. Thank you guys for being patient while I'm dealing with other stuff in the background. Okay? So let's take a look at the goddesses, African goddesses deck, and see what the collective needs to be made aware of right now. Show me what I need to see, please, Spirit, for the collective that's here. Show me what I need to see and not what I want to see. I just saw mask. So someone could be wearing a false mask around you. I'll take a look at it. Come in. Show me what I need to see. Oh, thanks. Just leave it. Thank you. Show me what I need to see, please, Spirit, for the collective. I definitely feel like there's something that you're not feeling like you're worthy of. Maybe you're having doubts about being worthy of something. This is that negative talk. It's that negative talk, okay? Show me what I need to see for this collective. Bottom of the deck is pleasure. Okay, so maybe you've in number 11. So twin flame energy. Okay, or also soulmate. So you could be meeting someone. Like I said, I feel like there's something coming in towards you. Show me what I need to see for the collective. What's the overall energy for this collective here? Show me what I need to see. Good morning. Good morning. We got etheric cords. We got this yesterday for the twin flame. So there could be some etheric cords that you have ties with someone, collective, that you need to break. You need to cut those cords with this person, okay? I'm not sure how you have to do it. I don't know if forgiveness is needed. I don't know if you just need to have a conversation with this person and let the past be the past. Whatever it is, there's etheric cords that you need to cut with someone. Okay, and just let it go, because I feel like something new is coming towards you. Okay, bottom of the deck is radical rebirth. You're going through a massive change, and Spirit is trying to warn you to let things go out of your life. And I say warn you because it's a number 5 and it's a change. Spirit is trying to transform you, put you through something, to take you through something to get you to somewhere better. And if you continue to hold on to the things that no longer serve you, Spirit will kick them out of your life one way or another. So, you know, just be ready for that. So the number 27, which is a 9, which means something is ending, and it has to be these ties that you have with these etheric cords that you have with this person. Okay, it's time for it to end, because it's time to move on. Okay, so if it isn't wholehearted love, release it. Remember your worth. The energy cords binding you and someone you no longer wish to be attached to are strong. You must be willing to let go. Close your eyes. See divine swords of God's love, loving light separating you and dissolving the cords between you. You are both whole and healed. Just as you shower to cleanse physical grime, there is also grime in the form of energy cords, also called karmic ribbons, emotional cords, or etheric cords. Spiritual maintenance is required. The declaration is, I am worthy, compassionate, and whole. I definitely feel like some of you right now are having an issue with self-worth. And if you are, then you need to make sure that you're deep diving, like I said, and go within and find out, why are you having that issue? Why is it coming up right now? What are you facing right now? What are you dealing with right now that is causing this trigger for you to be worried about, you know, if you're worthy? You know that you're worthy. You're here for a reason, okay? You are worthy of whatever it is that you want to bring into your life. It doesn't matter what it is, okay? As long as it's on your path and spirit agrees with it, you know, it'll happen. But you gotta take the first moves to make it happen. Show me what I need to see for this collective. Come into this reading, spirit. This is my hip hop queens. Show me what I need to see for this collective. Come into this reading, spirit. Come into this reading, spirit, for this collective. I feel the massive change and the rebirth too. Bottom of the deck is angel. Oh, nice. So collective, you guys are very protected at this time. Okay? You have an angel watching over you. Okay? Or you could be an earth angel. Show me what I need to see for this collective. Show me what I need to see for this collective. What's the overall energy? Give me one more. Thank you. We got that yesterday. We got instincts on the bottom of the deck. Lotto. Some of you guys could be biracial. Or you could be in biracial relationship. Behind that, we got dominance. And ambition. Nice. Behind that is luck. So, wow, collective. There's a lot coming in towards you. Okay? We got knowledge coming out. And also superstition. So definitely feel like you guys are deep diving, getting more knowledge, gaining more spiritual knowledge, growing, becoming fruitful. Look at her shirt. You could be trying to do this for your family. You could be a generational curse breaker. Okay? Let's see what these are. So Bahamaria. It's not the worst idea for you to bone up on some skills that may have gotten a little rusty. Educationally speaking, even if you feel like your experiences have taught you so much, seek out new books to feed you more. Going back to school, taking online classes, or learning a new language, these are all good starts. Bahamaria's card reflects a constant quest for knowledge. Even when you feel lost, you'll have the gift of knowledge and be glad you stayed one step ahead in the game. Just know where the ledge is. So yeah, definitely feel like no matter how, you know, experienced you are or what you've been through and all of that, you could always learn more. Like, we never know everything. You know, the man that thinks that they know it all is dumb, okay? And the man that knows that he doesn't know it all is very wise. Okay, so just understand that as you grow and as you learn on your spiritual path, you're always growing, you're always learning, okay? So definitely feel like, don't ever make yourself feel like you know what you're doing. You can always brush up on your skills. There could always be a YouTube channel that teaches you something, or, you know, you could go out in your community and learn something. So continue to grow, continue to put in the knowledge so that you can share it with others, okay? And then we have Kehlani, superstitious. So some of you guys could be feeling reluctant with the superstition, reluctant to do something, or maybe you just have old wives' tales that you hold on to. And I feel like, you know, with the knowledge here and the superstition, it's making me feel like you need to let go of some of those old superstitions that you have, or some of those old stereotypes that you have, okay? And understand that reading and learning will help you get rid of those, okay? Good morning, okay? So understand that there's so much out there for you to explore. Let go of some of those old ways of thinking, okay? They're not doing you any good. They're holding you back and keeping you stagnant. Sometimes you don't know how hot the stove is until you touch it. But you don't have to spend your life showing off a bunch of burn marks. The Kehlani card is a sign. Do not pass go. Whether in love, friendship, career, whatever your gut instincts signal you for a reason. Resist the extreme, but so overly cautious that you're paralyzed, unable to make a move. Be thoughtful in your actions. And if something doesn't feel right, then it probably isn't. So definitely listen to your intuition about people, places, things. It doesn't matter. Listen to your intuition. If something does not feel right, collective, it's not right. You know that, okay? So don't try to make it right just because, you know, you're used to it. Or because, you know, that's just how so-and-so is. If it doesn't feel right, it's not right. If you're in a situation and you're getting this feeling in your stomach like, you need to get out of here, then honestly, make an exit. Try to figure it out, okay? All right. So let's get into the childhood. Good morning. Good morning. How are you? Show me what I need to see, please, Spirit, for this collective. What inner child workings do we need to be made aware of for this collective? This, if you're new here, this is my inner child fairy tale cards. They help you work on your inner child, work on healing your inner child. And it's just not if you're a reader. Like, if you get the book is very informative. Okay? So, you know, get the book. Play with the cards if you want. Pull a card for yourself every day and look at the meaning of it and see what it means for you. Okay? The cards and the oracles and stuff like that, it's not just for the readers, guys. It's for you guys to learn too, okay? Show me what I need to see for this collective. What do I need to see for this collective? Shuffle. Bottom of the deck is the Three of Wands. So you could be waiting on something. There could be some expansion coming in the future. We got Earth Child. Wow. So you guys could definitely be Earth Angels, Star Seeds. Okay. People that were sent here to make a difference on this Earth. There's some type of expansion coming in for you, okay? Here. You could have a spirit baby. I believe that's the World card. Show me what I need to see for this collective. What do I need to see for this collective? Show me what I need to see. Ooh, that's a lot, Spirit. Bottom of the deck is the Three of Swords. So we had the Three of Wands, and now we got the Three of Swords. Wow. I feel like some of you are, yeah, Five of Swords, the little wreck. Okay. Some of you are worried about fucking up. You're worried about expanding or growing and messing it up. And you're worried about getting your heart broken as well. You're worried about, yeah, you're worried about sabotaging yourselves. Be careful with that, okay? Stop the negative thoughts. Get out of your head. We got the Ten of Wands coming out here. Also, Sleeping Beauty and Rapunzel. Wow. We got two major arcana coming out. The Ten of Wands, even though it usually depicts someone laying down some burdens, I feel like this is like an after the Ten of Wands here. This woman is chilling in the grass, okay? got butterflies all around her, been through a transformation with all the butterflies, okay? So that's why I feel like this Ten of Wands is like the after the Ten of Wands, okay? Which is a new beginning, which is the Ace of Wands. So this could be a new home, a new backyard, or something new here coming in. Then we have Sleeping Beauty and Rapunzel, which is the tower. I know that that's the tower, but I'm not sure what Sleeping Beauty is. So let's take a look in a book. We'll start with the Ten of Wands, okay? Let's see what page the Ten of Wands is on. The Ten of Wands is on 157, which is a 13, which is a 4, which is about your stability. So this could definitely be a move or something that's happening here, okay? Some type of a transformation, a full transformation, a full rebirth here, okay? So 157. Once the decision is made to cross the threshold into a magical garden, the long journey toward rebirth reaches its destination. This is what I'm saying. Like, that's what I just said. Like, I feel like someone is going to a new place, a new, you know, world, a new... It's going to happen all of a sudden with this tower here. Like, you're not expecting this, but it's going to be so beautiful and so... Look at all the flowers. It's going to be growing, fresh, beautiful, serene. So wherever you've been... You're not going to be there no more. Here we go again with the house. That's why there's a house on this card too that we pulled. Something different is coming in for you. This is why you have to let go of those ties that you have. Okay? The fairy who was gazing into the garden in the Nine of Wands is now entering and experiencing a spiritual homecoming in the Ten of Wands. The multicolored butterflies on the gate have been transformed into the crown of white butterflies, creating a divine aura of protection and guidance. The fairy holds in her hand the magic wand, tipped with a beautiful rainbow butterfly, symbolizing her initiation into states of higher consciousness. So not only are you flourishing on the outside, but on the inside, you're also getting to higher realms, higher consciousness, okay? 3D, 4D, 5D, okay? The number 9 is in numerology often suggests completion, while the qualities inherent in 10 are rejuvenation and exaltation. With 9 white butterflies encircling her and the 10th now a part of her magical wand, this fairy is ready for new responsibilities and service in the intuitive arts, healing, art, music, dance, and ritual. So there could be something in your gifts that you could use in order to be able to get where you're trying to get. Also, I feel like you're having a boost in your intuitive gifts. In your intuitive arts. So make sure you're practicing the things that are, you know, your talents, your gifts, so that they can continue to grow. Because at this time, they're being experiencing a lot of growth. Thank you so much. While meditating on this card, realize that you are being crowned. Your auric field is being purified. And like the white butterflies, you are set free to explore the infinite circle of your higher self. The rainbow butterfly is offered to you as a bridge connecting your life of service to the greater community, humanity, and the earth evolving in the cosmos. I mean... It doesn't get any clearer than that. Like, you're going through a major rebirth right now, inside and on the outside. If you haven't started seeing it on the outside, it will happen. And I'm not talking about the physical you. I'm talking about things around you. You'll start seeing things change, seeing things grow, okay? But you gotta dive deep, and you need to let go of some things, okay? Because Spirit is trying to bring something in here for you. Okay, what's the Sleeping Beauty? So on number 93, which is a 12, which is a 3, and we just had 4, so this sounds like a countdown, okay? So something's about to come in for you. 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, yesterday we had the countdown too. 6, 5, 4. Now we're at 4, 3. Well, okay. Do y'all hear me? Something is trying to come in. I'm big on numbers, y'all. I can't stand math, but I am big on numbers when it comes to numerology. Sleeping Beauty 93, okay. All right, it's a long one, but Sleeping Beauty is death. Scorpio energy, more transformation energy, and then the Tower. Wow. Major, major transformations here, collective. This could also be on a world level, I'm feeling like there's gonna be some major transformations that's taking place for the collective on a major level. Like, there's transformation all through this reading. We got the Death and the Tower, Scorpio energy. Also Aries, Leo, Sagittarius with the Ten of Wands. But Scorpio energy very strong in this reading. So let's read what we can from Sleeping Beauty. I'll read what I can because this is a lot, but I'll read a few things here that I'm looking at. When this card appears in your reading, a long period of contemplation may be needed. Do not be afraid of the quiet growth occurring within. Enter the world of dreams, archetypes, and symbols with courage and emotional calm. Learn while you are in a receptive state. Doing something externally is not always an answer. Let go of the past. Like the caterpillar changing into a butterfly. Wow. A magical process is underway in the depths of your being. Dive deep. I'm telling you, dive deep. Eventually, you will sprout wings and soar like an eagle over formerly uncharted realms of knowledge. The process of metamorphosis is dangerous, but every child must go through this incubation period before becoming an adult. So remember, this is about your inner child, okay? So there could be some things in your inner child that you are still trying to work through, that you're still trying to change, okay, as an adult, okay? The young person must leave the safety net of childhood. But the joys and sorrows of that time span will live on in the imagination. This card also suggests the healing power of sleep. Without enough rest, the cells of the body cannot function properly, and the immune system is stretched to its limit. See the peace and quiet of sleep as an interlude of tranquility and recuperation. During sleep, the soul loosens its grip on the physical body and roams the spiritual universe, while still maintaining its tie to the body through the silver cord or the thread of consciousness. Enjoy this nightly excursion into another realm of existence and bring back the fruits of those experiences in the forms of amazing dreams, visions, and plans for the future. So Scorpio energy, like I said, Spirit is urging you to let go of the past because they're trying to bring in this rebirth, total rebirth in your life. Like, you're not going to recognize your own life, okay? So stop holding on to the past so that you can get this new person, new life. It looks like life to me, all of it, abundance. And I'm not just talking about money. I'm talking about joy, love, okay? Experiences, travel, business, okay? So then we have Rapunzel, which is the tower. I know that that's the tower. So there could be some storms brewing in the background of your life right now. Okay. But I feel like help is on the way. Okay. So Rapunzel is on 107, which is an 8, which is about abundance. And what was I just saying? So 107. This is the tower. Mars energy. I'm not really sure where Mars is right and what it's located right now and what sign it's in. But I know Mercury, I think, is in Aries today, and I think it's in Pisces as well. Lots of fire. When this card appears in your reading, be prepared for transformative experiences. Like, I can't make it up. Spirit is trying to bring in experiences to you that will change the way that you see things, change the way that you live your life, change the way that you eat, drink, walk, talk, okay? That's what's coming in towards you, okay? So be ready. The only certainty now is change and metamorphosis. The only certain, unexpected and shocking events may be on the horizon. So there's things coming that you are not expecting. I'm trying to tell you, good or bad, we see them as good or bad, but all of them are just experiences, guys, okay? There are lessons for us to learn, good and bad. But I feel like this, with this unexpected and shocking events, this is not bad. I feel like what is coming through is to clear out what you no longer need, because something very new and abundant is coming your way, okay? Purge your ego of old desires, fears, and grudges. A sudden mental breakthrough can help release you from your personality attachments and limitations. Just as Rapunzel's beautiful golden braid was chopped off by the enchantress in order to banish her from her loving prince or her active will, so is your ego consciousness being refined and changed. It is time to cut away the strands of the past that connect you to old karma and worn out patterns and emerge into the purity and clarity of a revived future. I'm trying to tell you, Spirit is trying to change your whole life. Spirit is trying to change your whole life. Ooh, I got the chills. Okay, so whatever this is coming towards you to clear out things, a whole new world is coming after that. But you got to trust and believe, okay, and do your inner work. Break those cords. Let go of these old karmic ties, okay? Stop doing karmic shit. Stop hanging around karmic people. I don't care if it's your family, okay? Stop. Come into this reading, Spirit. Okay, that was long. Sorry, y'all. A little mermaid, guys. A whole new world. I'm not doing signs. I'm doing a collective energy read. Okay. Come into this reading, Spirit. Some of you guys could garden. Some guys you could love to garden. Maybe you recently started trying to get ready for your garden. Show me what I need to see, please, Spirit. For the collective. What are the crystals? This is resonating. Good, I'm glad. Show me what I need to see. Bottom of the deck is emerald. Unconditional love, beauty, recovery, and healing past lives. That's what Spirit it wants us focusing on, getting rid of all that karmic energy, because there's new shit that they're trying to bring in, stuff you've never experienced before. Emerald, Follow the yellow brick road to the Emerald City. I don't know why I'm hearing this. That is this city where the Wizard of Oz, wherever you want, all your dreams can come true. I know that this sounds really corny, but this is what I'm getting here, okay? Show me what I need to see for this collective. What else? Bottom of the deck is Pyrite. Good change of fortune, success, renewed focus, and leadership. So Pyrite, okay? We got Selenites, psychic insights, blessings, fidelity, and deep connection. So there's a deep connection coming in towards you that's going to shock you. Something that you've never experienced before. Also feel, like I said earlier, like your psychic abilities are growing. All of your intuition, your discernment, at this time, you need to make sure you're putting them to use because they're growing. And blessings are coming towards you. I can't make it up. Blessings. Blue topaz, finding a spiritual ally. So this could be a very spiritual connection that you're getting into. Okay, we have higher wisdom, abundance, I can't make it up, and forgiveness. Okay, so like I said earlier, there could be someone that you need to forgive in order to let go of the feelings of the past. Okay, again, it does not mean that you have to allow this person back into your energy. It just means that you're moving on for you, okay? Forgiveness is all about you. It's never about the other person, okay? Then we got Peridot. Well-being, attracting money, good luck charm, and healing heartbreak, okay? So there's a lot of healing going on here that's going to be happening for you in the future. I feel a lot of healing energy around the collective, healing all kinds of heartbreak, attracting that money. I'm telling you, something very abundant is trying to come towards you. So please don't block this. We got hematite, self-healing, grounding, right opportunities, and justice. So your justice is coming in. This is meant for you. Whatever this is, it's meant for you. Okay, we're going to do some tarot now. Oh, thank you so much. Nice. How do you know? If someone is continuously teaching you lessons and making you cry and treats you like shit and doesn't see the worth or value in you, they're karmic. Family, friends, people on the street. Okay, show me what I need to see. And if you're still not sure, get a reading. I can let you know if the person that you're dealing with is a karmic. Show me what I need to see for this collective. What is the overall energy for this collective here, Spirit? What do we need to know? What do we need to know? Uh-oh. I just saw the Queen of Swords, so y'all could be cutting some motherfuckers off, but I did tell y'all to break those cords, okay? We got the Emperor coming out here and the Three of Swords. Somebody could be healing or somebody could be in their feelings about something. Show me what I need to see. Queen of Cups coming out. Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. Show me what I need to see for this collective. What's going on for this collective? What do they need to be made aware of? There could be something that you need to be patient with, okay? And I feel like you're waiting on it, but continue to be patient. Show me what I need to see. I feel like once you get it, there's going to be a decision that you're going to have to make. So be ready for that decision, that for whatever this is. Yeah, Two of Swords. Bottom of the deck. Yeah, you're going to be having to do some contemplation. Oh, God, don't be in your head. There's going to be some type of a decision that's going to put you in your head. Okay, you're really going to be contemplating this. This could be someone else in your energy as well. Virgo energy, also Aquarius, Libra, Gemini. Very strong. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius as well. I feel like you could be waiting on some type of a decision and it's causing you, or you're waiting on something and it's causing some type of stress or something in your life here. But when it comes in, you're going to have to make a quick decision. Okay, here. Show me what I need to see for this collective. What's the overall energy for this collective? We got the Ace of Wands. I can't make it up. Something is coming in here for this collective. Something passionate, something that's going to give to you, okay? Show me what I need to see. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius with the Ace of Wands. We have the Five of Swords in the reverse. This is something that is going to be good for you, that's not going to sabotage you, that you're not going to sabotage yourself with, okay, with the Five of Swords in the reverse. Oh, come on, collective. Three of Swords coming out here. Five of Swords in the reverse. It just makes me feel like you guys are really scared. Like you guys got a fear of something new coming in here. Like you're scared of something new because you're worried about it turning out like before. Get those feelings of the past out of your mind. The past is gone. This is a whole new cycle for you. This is a whole new cycle. If you concentrate on what you don't want, that is what you're going to bring in. But if you concentrate on what you do want, that is what you're going to bring in. So don't sit in your head and be like, but I don't want to get my heart broken again. Okay, we know that. Okay, we all know that. However, don't say it, don't think it. I'm just going to put the work into this the way that I'm supposed to. I'm going to chillax and just let things flow. Don't try to control the situation. Okay? Don't try to control how the relationship flows. Let it just flow. You never know what you're going to get. Get out your motherfucking head. Okay? Show me what I need to see. What else for this collective? What else? I know that wasn't the Ten of Swords. Okay. It's not going to end the same way that it did before. However, if you concentrate on that energy, it will. It will. Okay? Because that's the law of attraction. Okay, it's not going to end the way that it did before. But understand, people are in our lives for a reason and for a season. Not always forever. And so you have to let go of those attachment issues. We was talking about that before. Let go of those attachment issues. Don't be attached to things, people, places. They are not yours. They are for your experience. They are for your growth. They are for your wisdom. Even your children ain't yours. I don't care how long you was in labor with them. Okay? They're a gift. They're a blessing for you to share with the world because they have gifts and they have talents and they have blessings. And all you are there to do is just be like the, you know, at the bowling lane, when you take your kids when they're young and they got them guards, that's you. You make sure that they stay out the damn gutter. That's your job. Okay, that's it. Show me what else I need to see for this collective. The Seven of Wands. Yes, putting your guard down because this is not going to end up in a Ten of Swords in the upright. It's going to end up in the Ten of Swords in the reverse. You're not going to have to worry about this being a Ten of Swords. This is the Ten of Swords is behind you. The past is in the past. Let it be there. Okay? What else? The Four of Swords. Healing. So we got the Three of Swords, the Four of Swords, and the Five of Swords. It's going to be healing. So get out of your head. victory on the bottom of the deck. Six of Wands. It's not going to turn out like that. So don't think it is. Look, you're going to be celebrating. Three of Cups. Victory. So get out of your head and get out of your way. Okay? All right. So let's look at the past life energy for the collective and see what we need to work on when it comes to our past lives. Now I'll stop preaching, y'all. And show me what I need to see for this collective, for our past life energy that we need to work on. What do we need to work on as a collective? Show us what we need to work on as a collective, please, Spirit. Hello, hello. How are you? You're very welcome. Thank you for the follows. I'm getting on you right now. Okay, sweet. Called out for real. All right. Show me what I need to see. Bottom of the deck is authority figures. An orphan. So some of y'all could have abandonment issues. Some of you could have Native American ties. You could have been abandoned by a father. Show me what I need to see for this collective. What do we need to work on? We got finances. I'm trying to tell you, it's coming in. What else for this collective? Thank you. Bottom of the deck is trees. So trees could be very significant to you. You could also be very tall. Makes me feel like you have a, maybe you're a grower. I'm seeing somebody, I don't want to say what I'm seeing, but I see somebody in a tree. Let me say that. That's all I can say. So somebody's ancestors here could have a lot of experience with trees, if you know what I mean. All right, so we got finances and ships. Also, Atlantis, wow. You could be a water sign, not necessarily. And or a Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn with the finances here, okay? Give me a second. So you could definitely have a connection to the city of Atlantis, okay? Maybe you could have ran away from one area to another on a ship, escaped an area. Maybe finances have always been an issue for you, or maybe they have never been an issue for you at the end of the spectrum. Either way, I feel like there could be some travel in your future and some finances that are really going to be looking good in your future. But right now, this is the past energy that we're working on as a collective. And I feel like travel and finances as a collective is something that we're all kind of working on. My God. Oh, wow, Robin. I love it. Wow, y'all. Trees are very precious to me. Oh, nice. Wow. All right, so Atlantis. Your lifetime is in ancient Atlantis is affecting your current situation. You have soul memories of this idyllic civilization that offered very imaginable wonder. There's a longing for the utopia that you unconsciously remember and which you know is possible in this world. Your soul also remembers the tragic ending of Atlantis, and you may have developed phobias about the ocean as a result. Although you love the sea, perhaps you prefer not to go swimming or sailing. You also recall how the majority of Atlanteans were peaceful people and loving, with the exception of a few political leaders. Remember, we had the authority figures on the bottom of the deck.
political leaders who misused crystal power to detriment of all. Oh, wow. So you may be extra sensitive to issues relating to political corruption in this lifetime. So you could, I just got the chills. So some of you could really be into politics. Maybe you're thinking about getting into politics, trying to change your community. Maybe you're already like a public speaker type person who talks about the issues or something like this here. You could be dealing with a water sign or you could be a water sign, but definitely you could have memory. Dolphins could mean something to you as well. Could be your spirit animal. I hear there's buried treasure. There's buried treasure. All right, finances. Your relationship with money is being affected by your past life experiences. For instance, you may have had a lifetime of extreme poverty or even wealth. Many people struggle to save money because their own other lifetimes involve communal wealth where the convent, tribe, or village, thank you so much, provided for everyone's needs. In those lifetimes, there was no such thing as individual savings accounts or separate possessions. As a result, you may find that your finances are a perplexing and upsetting mystery. Your income may roller coaster up and down until you come to terms with the fact that you're currently incarnated in a Western capitalistic society that operates on individualism. To heal this situation, understand that money is merely energy and can be used for good purposes or negative ones. Know that money in itself is neutral. It is what you do with it that matters. Act with the intention to help the world through charity and generosity. This is a noble virtue. I also want to say that if you do give of yourself, energy is energy, money is energy. What you put out, you get back tenfold. Like, you do. You do. In so many other ways. Not just in material ways, but you do. Like, being charitable to other people and helping people through things that you yourself have already experienced is the way that the world is supposed to go. It's not supposed to be just about me. Yes, be about yourself. Learn how to love yourself first so that you can love other people appropriately, okay? But it's really not just about you, okay? Finances. Your relationship with money, I already did that one. Ships. Your prior lifetime spent on ships bring this card to you today. As a former sailor, crew member, or ship passenger, you've had experiences at sea that have exerted an influence on the situation you're inquiring about. You probably already have a sense of the type of life you had aboard these ships. The question now becomes how your experiences have affected your present life. Negative reactions such as fears and phobias, or positive reactions such as longings to travel or a special affinity for the ocean. All may have arisen in prior lifetimes. So you could have always been drawn to taking cruises or going towards water or going on a ship or feeling like you want to be on a ship or something like this here. And it's because in your past life, you did a lot of travel or you were always on a ship in some type of capacity. So I definitely feel like there's more of all of this coming in your future. Finances, traveling in the water, going to different places to just seek treasure. Because I'm hearing there's hidden treasure. There's hidden treasure. And I don't know what that means. That's for somebody. I don't know. All right, you guys. So that is the collective reading, energy check-in for today. I was going to do feminine, but Spirit said I needed to do the energy check-in, so for the collective. And so there it is. I hope that it gave you the clarity and insight that you needed today. Okay. Yeah, I'm terrified. Yes, this was a collective. You're very welcome. You're very welcome. I think that's it. I don't think anyone got a reading today, which is good, because I got shit to do. I gotta get myself together. I love y'all. I'll see y'all probably this evening or something like that, because it's a busy day for me. And I need to do some self-care. And my nails look horrible. So I'm gonna go get my nails done too. I love y'all, and I'll talk to you soon. Oh, okay. Well, hi, D. Well, good. Good. I'm glad. What was that? Real talker. Thank you. You guys take care. I'll be back later on. Bye.